intergalactic planet jumping, planet jumping, intergalactic, 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 another dimension, another dimension, another dimension, another dimension.
Another comic chest. I'm not sure if you watched my last one, but the theme of this month is robots. And I am excited for that. I don't know about you, but I love me some robots. So without further ado, I'm trying so hard to behave myself. Don't do it. Don't do it. Cool. Robots! Thank you. Thank you, Comic Chest. What's the deal with this paper? It is thick. Getting the quality shit from Dunder Mifflin or what? In case you're wondering what this is, just a little checklist of what's inside. Touch on this later. That's what we call a foreshadow. Okay, coming soon flyer. Out of time. Sweet. So, next month's theme is out of time. I'm assuming some kind of time travel theme. Maybe get some Cable stuff in there, huh? Big fan of Cable. That's next month. I did do some aggressive robot shaking, but I did find one Starburst. I'm sure the rest are in there somewhere. First covers trading card series, you got Machine Man. This is a comic book cover from 1984. Awesome. And they turned it into a card. Machine Man. Do you like the artwork of the 80s? It was very robot-esque, you know? A lot of wires and circles and lines going on there. I love it. And how could you possibly have a comic chest robot theme without some Terminator cards, huh? Sarah Connor. This is some kind of Terminator game, which is cool. I just don't understand how to play. Do you remember the punks from the first Terminator? You see Bill Paxton there? Bill Paxton in the middle. R.I.P. I believe Bill Paxton is the only guy that's been killed by a Terminator, an alien, and a Predator. I'm pretty sure. And if you're like McGuff, Bill Paxton wasn't killed by a Predator, then you haven't seen Predator 2, have ya? Get the fuck out of here.
They gave us a card for the parking lot.
And to go with the parking lot, we've got a card of the city street. Close up and personal, Miss Sarah Connor, mother of the future savior of the world. Automated assembly line, that's the assembly line robot in the factory. No idea what this is, but it looks cool. The Conqueror. Okay, Oath of Allegiance Delta Company. See that? Oath of Allegiance, I don't even know what that's a picture of. And I'm not gonna read this because I don't feel like it. Eagle Watch, you got yourself some Kyle Reese there. Daddy of the future savior of the world. That's a, you know, that's a machine gun from a robot. Cool. There's some Starburst. There's another one. All right, let's get into these comic chest cards. All right, I don't know if you guys know who Warlock is. Warlock is a robot from the future, is that right? I forget, I think he's a futuristic robot though, but here he is turning himself into a sail ship. Classic Sentinel from 1995. That's cool. Tyrant, what did I say about those robots before? Very stringy. They like to do cables as hair for robots a lot of times. That's fun. Yeah, Steel Clan from Gargoyles. I don't know if you know who Siege is, but you know, wires and circles. If you're familiar with comic chests, you know they come with a couple of vintage figures, because that's awesome. One of these vintage figures, this guy,
He's got some weight to him. We'll open this guy first.
Robots, robots.
Hey, I know who this is. Yes. If I'm not mistaken, that's Deathlok.
1992. That is crazy.
I don't know if you remember, but Deathlok was in Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. 90s loved their utility belts and gun bags. Deathlok. Collectible. Let's do it. Obviously, it's a Funko. Don't want to ruin that Funko box, so we'll just... Oh, yeah. Oh, nice. This is nice. As I was saying, got to be careful so we don't ruin the box. A lot of collectors out there don't want to upset them. Android 16 from Dragon Ball Z. This will go nicely with my other Dragon Ball characters. Am I pointing right? Yeah, right there. Here you go. Cool. And that box is in pretty good shape. Whew. Hey! Since we already started opening the box. Oopsies. Oops. My bad. Yeah, Android 17. He's got the full mohawk going. He's got his bird. This is awesome. There you go. 16. Did I say 17? I meant 16. He's got his little bird on his arm because he's a friendly android. He's got the full green outfit going on. Check out that mohawk. Yeah. Good Funko. I like it a lot. Goes well with my other DBZ characters. Awesome. What could this be, I wonder? Possibly some Heroclix. Have you even ever heard of Heroclix before? Heroclix are these mini action figures with these mini dials on the bottom. You take these mini action figures and you throw them onto a tabletop. Cause that's right, it's a tabletop board game. It's your turn. You figure out a strategy of how you want to fight your opponents. And once you start that fight, the battle is on. The last Heroclix standing is the one that wins. Heroclix. And that's a brief synopsis of what Heroclix is. Oh, Mac. Look at the quality. They were able to get abs into this little guy. Check out the dial on the bottom. That's how you play the game, okay? The Mandroid. Who wouldn't want a brown suit of armor, you know? Mr. Wildfire floating in. Cool suit. Cool. Cool suit. That's a good pose, too. Very Spider-Man-esque. I think this guy's called the Fugitoid. I don't know, you tell me. Look. How do you say that? Fugitoid? Fugitoid? Fidgetoid? Anyway, that's that guy. Got himself a little hand cannon there. Or are those just his fingies? Second vintage figure. It? Ooh. Oh, yes. What? Hold on, hold on. What is this all about? Oh, sweet. All right, hold on. Okay. This is cool, dude. Oh, how did I do that? Okay, hold on. Oh, man. Okay, it's like a cyborg Wolverine, and his arms pop off, and they gave me a second set of arms. Check it out. So he's like, yep, cyborg Wolverine, robo-Wolverine, if you will. 1994. All right, check us out. Ready? Are you ready? Hey! And let's put those other arms in there. Yeah, dude. Look at these arms. Look at that. It's got the claws. Check out that eyeball. 1994. Yeah, like that wasn't inspired by T2. Come on. This is dope. Look, you want to see the arms again? Now that I'm looking at this too, what is this? What were they doing in 1994 where they're like, what if we just sewed handcuffs to his body? I don't think Wolverine would be down for that kind of treatment, you know what I'm saying? Last thing in here, we got 10 comic books, yo. Every comic chest comes with 10 comic books. That's one story arc and a bunch of cool loose issues. Let's see what we got. Every comic has a comic grade card on the back, lets you know what it's worth. On the streets. All right, so right off the bat here, I'm not gonna be able to pronounce all of these. Sorry.
Ultimate Vision from the Ultimate Marvel Universe. Looks like Vision is a chick here, is that right? Got some good purples going on there. Curious about that. If you're not familiar, after the death of Superman, you got the reign of the Supermen. One of them's a robot. That's cool. I don't have any Reign of the Superman comics, so this is nice. As mentioned before, Deathlok. Look at that font. Could you get more robotic with the font? And of course, you got wires and circle. Speaking of wires, live wires. Looks like a team of kids doing some, doing some adventures there, having some adventures. Live wires. Never heard of them. This is where my pronunciations get questionable, okay? We've got a couple of story arcs here. One of them is called Automatic Kafka. Automatic Kafka. Is that how you say it? Who's familiar with this? Let me know. And you got yourself a robot arm. Check it out. It's like I have the arm, right? Oh, jeez. This might be one of the creepiest covers I've ever seen. Automatic Kafka 2. What is that, a robot baby? A freaky robot baby? And on the top, you've got a roller coaster with a very excited person up there. See the excitement lines? What a weird, cool, creepy comic book cover. I really like that. And I'm gonna lose sleep over it. Automatic Kafka 3, you got a robot guy. And it looks like he's getting busy with a lady. Not sure if it's a robot lady, but also he doesn't seem like he's very into it. I've never heard of this series. I'm very curious about it. Then we got a few here from, it looks like, Alan Moore and Leah Moore and John Ripperton. And it's called Albion? Albion? I don't know how to say it. Maybe I say it with an English accent, it'll make more sense. Albion. Yeah, that's better. Albion. Looks like an Iron Man helmet. I don't know what's up with that. Sure enough, you got another Albion. Looks like a chick in France. And if I had to guess, she's hanging out in a room with NSYNC. Huh. You got a very scared open eyeball. Albion, the eyeball. That's the comic chest. How about it? Robot edition. Yeah, that was fun. Let's recap from the foreshadow from earlier, all right? In this comic chest, we have 10 comic books, one box collectible, two vintage action figures, a pack of HeroClix, and a pack of cards. If you want a comic chest, go to their social media. That can lead you to how to get one. They got a website. You can order one on there. You can hit them up. They'll be like, yo, what do you want in your chest? And then you say, yo, I like this. And then they'll go, oh, we'll curate that to your likes. And then you get the stuff you like. It's wonderful. Comic chest links in the description. I don't know how to move like a robot, okay? Fuck. I've always wanted to, though. See ya! Subscribe!